गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास सिक्स सेकेंड चैप्टर सेकेंड पार्ट। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस द प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट ऑफ द दिस चैप्टर, दैट हाउ टू क्रिएट फोल्डर, हाउ टू क्रिएट सब फोल्डर विदिन अ फोल्डर, हाउ टू मूव और कॉपी एंड हाउ टू डिलीट एंड रीनेम फोल्डर। इन दिस पार्ट फर्स्ट वी विल चेक द थियोरेटिकल part of the this chapter and then after we will go again for the practical. File management organization of data is the chapter name. So here we will discuss about the some few topics. Folders are used to organize file, as I have discussed also. Folder are used to organize files, although they may contain other folders and subfolders too. Second is transfer of data from one drive to another can be done either by moving files or folders or by copying them and then pasting on the another drive. There's a two method to copy to transfer data from one location to another. First is copy and second is move. What we'll do if we will copy the file? Copying of a file folder means to create a duplicate copy of the selected file folder. Means if you are copying, if you are using a copy option, there will be two file and folder. Second is moving. Moving file folder means shifting it from one from its original location to another location. Moving means it will go to the another location and it will be deleted from the original location. Hope this copy and moving is clear. And what is the folder? Organization of data. What is the meaning of organization of data? It includes creating and managing files and folders so that we may access them easily. Why we organize our data and files? To access them easily. Easily we can search any file and folder, and anything if you want to search, we can easily access them. Next is, we can work with the multiple application at the time. Multiple application means at the same time, if we are working two and three application, multiple means more than two, with the help of flip feature. In computer we can easily work with the multiple application with the help of flip features. So what we have to do to use the flip feature? First, press and hold the alt key. Press and hold. While pressing the alt key, you have to press the tab key. While pressing the alt key, press the tab key, then the flip view will open. We will check how we have to use this alt key and press the tab key together to check the multiple application together. Next is file extension. As we know that whatever we are saving, either it is a document, if we are working in MS Excel, PowerPoint, each file saved with the extension. With extension is the identification of that file. So if we are saving document, a file saved in a Microsoft Word has the extension .doc or .docx, .docx or .doc. Spreadsheet, if you are working in MS Excel, a spreadsheet created in MS Excel has the extension .xls. If you have worked in MS Excel and you have saved your file, then extension of this MS Excel file will be .xls. If we have saved image in our computer, then extension will be .gif, .jpg and etc. Audio files, if we have saved audio files, any mp3 songs, then the name extension of this file will be .mp3. Presentation, if you have made any presentation using the PowerPoint, then the extension will be .ppt. So this is the identification of all the documents or images that what extension used for what files. Now, searching file using wildcard character. If you have so many files and folder in your computer, then you want a particular file to search, then it is difficult one by one. If you will open the each folder and file, then you will search your file which one you want. So it is difficult to find. It will take too much time to find your particular file and folder. So there's a method, a quick method to search your file and folder, which is called wildcard with the help of wildcard character. Wildcard are special symbols that can be used to search a file and folder. One more benefits of these file that if you forgot your file or folder name, that with which name you have saved your file and folder, then wildcard character provide the facility. If you remember the single digit that you have saved the file with the K letter, then with the help of wildcard character you can find your file and folder. Wildcard are special symbols that can use to search a file and folder whose exact name you do not know. There are two wildcard character, asterisk and question mark. With the help of asterisk, how can we use? As I said, if you remember the single alphabet that I just saved my file with the L character or L alphabet, then type L and then give asterisk sign. With the all the file will show with the name of L character. And question mark is used when you remember that with the name of Priya I have saved name, and then the another name I forgot, that after that what name I have given while saving the file, then after Priya you can give question mark and the file will show in your computer screen. Let's check the practical of all this commands. Let us start the practical. First we will check how to use multiple application. What you have to do, press the Alt key, and while pressing the Alt key, press the Tab key. See, we can see that there is a, we are switching with the different type of application. Hope these are clear, that how to use multiple, with which application you want to use, just release it and you will be in that application or Windows. Alt key, and then while pressing the Alt key, Tab key. And you can easily switch from one application to another application. This is the method to use multiple application together. And now how to search a file and folder. Go to the File Explorer. Here is the option for searching. See, here is, when you will click here, you can see all subfolder. It will search from all subfolder. So what you have to do, if I want to search with the P name, then as I have discussed in the wildcard character, that all the name with the P, you can see here with the name of P, all the files and folder will display. See, with the yellow color it is displaying. If I will use asterisk sign, and I want to search MP3, then with the name of P, it will display that in MP3 there's a two song. Hope that you can now understand what is the use of asterisk sign and question mark sign are also used if you forgot some letter and you want to, like, I remember only three letter and the another one I forgot, then just put the question mark and it will display. Then after that, array is the one folder which I have saved, and the another one, this one, and still it is searching that how many folder I have written with the ARR character. So now you can see how many folders with this ARR alphabet. So this is the method to use wildcard character. And there is the various option which we can use to organize our data. Like if you want to change the size, you can easily change. If you want to modify date and time, you can easily. How it will you want to view your desktop, you can manage your data. This is called organization of data. Now this chapter we have completed the second chapter also. This is basically for practical practice in your home, all the commands which I have discussed in the previous class. And now and then after, go to the fill-ups, question answer and MCQ. And in the fifth class I have given so many shortcut keys to cut, to paste, to copy, what shortcut key we have to use. So write all the shortcut keys in your notebook, and extension of all the files you have to write in your notebook. Just pause the video and write all the extension of the of the files. And then after this you have to write in your notebook all the extension of the files, and then shortcut keys and question answer. Now your second chapter also completed. Learn all the shortcut keys, extension and question answer. Write your notebook and learn. Thank you.